you've had an inGEN module installed on a vehicle to try and find out what the electrical loads are that are causing a dead battery syndrome. We've got the program loaded on our PC, the inGEN DAS for Diagnostic Analysis Software. So let's go ahead and open that up and then open up a file and see if we can identify where the problem might have been. You double click on the inGEN profile. Let's go to process data. We're going to open and decode. I've got the file loaded on my desktop. Left click that and open it. And you'll see that it counts down the files. When it gets all the information completed, it's going to go ahead and show us the main current and main voltage for the first 100 hours that are apportioned to this data sample. You'll also notice at the top of the screen that it's date and time stamped. As indicated here with 100 hours in the first file segment, main battery voltage, main battery current. We see some chatter on the left side of this screen where we're seeing some discharges. Each of these areas, though, when it's at operating voltage, we can see that the engine was started. We also have up here with the event cursor, we can come down here on each of these where you see an A. That's actually a high current impulse where we're seeing an engine start. That's the default event program that comes on every configuration file in the IDR. So anyway, we're going to go ahead and look at some of this detail. Let's zoom in. We'll take the zoom box. And let's just look at the first couple of hours here. We've got a lot of chatter that's going on. Let's look even a little bit closer. Let's only look at about 10 hours here. And now we can go ahead and enhance that by going zoom to fit. If you right click the top of each of those boxes, we can zoom that. And now we can see that we've got, place the cursor over the top of this. We can see that the first indication, 1804. Notice we're using military time here, so there's no confusion between AM and PM when we're reviewing the data. So here we are at essentially 6:04 PM, where we've got a discharge. We can see up here about 1.8 amps, and the battery voltage is 12.10. We can move that forward. We'll go from 18:04 hours. We see another impulse at 19:10, so just a little more than an hour. We see another one at 20:33. Same idea. Looks like there's a double impulse here at 21:30. Can we come back? 22:55. Something is causing this chatter. Exactly what? We don't know yet, but we can see that there's a pattern that's consistent. And that's one of the things that's a key to finding out when you've got a dead battery syndrome, what might have been happening with the vehicle. Let's go ahead up here and we'll zoom out to see all the data once again. To be clear, let's go ahead and keep the zoom box alive and look at hours, maybe 45 to 55, somewhere in that range. We can count here, each of these again is an event, so it's a start. We'll zoom once again, a little bit better resolution. Let's go ahead and look in detail at what the start looks like. We'll pick any one of these, and we can see now 60 seconds worth of high resolution data, what the voltage and current were like during that start event. We can replace the cursor and actually see that when we first started, we were up around 70 amps of recharge, and we got to regulated voltage pretty quickly. Again, within 10 seconds, we're out here at 13.4 volts and still at 21 amps. But you can see this profile. These data points can be zoomed in on as well if you need greater detail to analyze start events. Just like this. Okay, let's close this profile. I'm going to go back to the 100 hours, and I'm going to take my file shuttle box here, pull it up, and let's go forward 100 hours. We see that the vehicle was idled for quite some time, for about 3 days almost, but now we see some more starts come into view, and we see a couple of those blips that we saw initially in the file. Let's move forward another 100 hours. This is where the real problem shows up, where we got the battery that actually dies. In this file, I'm going to close this box, the file shuttle, and show you that we're actually in excess of 100 hours in this file. That's because after the battery died, we're down below 6 volts here, the inGEN actually turns off and stops recording data. So we've got some gaps here, and you can see that another key when you're looking at some information. If it doesn't look right, we can go back here and show the data points and disconnect the dots. Let's zoom in on this area. and we can see that there's a gap. That's an important key. If the unit shuts off, you don't know how long that gap is until you go ahead and investigate it. So you want to keep that in mind. We'll go back out to the full view, and I'm going to change that data control again. Data markers. I'm going to connect the dots. One of the other things, if you need to print this stuff out, you can go ahead and invert that background, and you can see that now we're not going to chew up the toner in the printer, which is an important thing. You can also save that, copy that picture to a clipboard if you wanted to, or save the file, or print it directly if you're hooked up to a printer. We'll go back and turn that screen back around. Let's look in detail at this shutdown sequence though. I'm still highlighted here, so I'm gonna zoom in. We see that the engine was running. Always love to zoom. We see that the engine was running here. Engine start at 1636, roughly, and it ran until approximately 1733, so about an hour's worth of runtime at this event. When it shut off, however, we can see that there's a pretty significant discharge load. Let's look at this in detail. We're down more than 15 amps of discharge at the shutoff sequence, and we can see that it latches on at over 3 amps of discharge. That's going to bring that battery, that single battery, down in a pretty quick fashion. And as we expand it back out again, let's go back and start to add some data a little bit out of control here. We're going to go back and zoom it this way. And we can see that we go off scale. Zoom it. There we go. This chatter that you're seeing in this area is just the module when it's actually shut off and it's like bouncing on the bottom. So that's the only issue that you're going to see there. And at this point, until it gets out to the very end, when we have the straight line going up, that's actually where the data is missing. We'll reconfirm by looking at it this way. Data's gone. We know what the load was, we know when it turned on. We know that it's intermittent, and we know that it happened very shortly after the engine was shut off. This is the type of information that's going to be important when you're analyzing vehicle problems with dead battery syndrome, or just to get a baseline of what a vehicle shutdown sequence looks like. If you have a reference file from a similar vehicle, you know, that doesn't have a problem, that's also helpful when you're looking at some of this data. There are some videos that are available on Midtronics website and on YouTube that help you, if you haven't seen them, for installing the module, the IDR-10 module, and also for extracting the module and getting the information on your SD data card.